Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be talking about 10 things that God loves. But before that, if you're new to my channel, my name is Leche Koza and I come up with videos that will help you with your spiritual journey. So if that's something that you need, consider subscribing and also press the bell icon so that you never miss any of my upcoming videos. By the way, many of you don't know yet what video of the month is. I introduced that in one of my previous videos and I'll put the link in the description below so that you can check it out if you haven't watched that yet. And today is the last day of submission, so those who haven't submitted yet, you can submit it next month. And I'll be very happy to receive videos from you. Now without wasting much time, let's get straight into the video. In my previous video, my mom shared about the things that God hates. And today in this video, I'm gonna be talking about the things you do that He loves. And these are simple things that you might do on a regular basis, but you might not even be aware that these are the things that God loves. So now let's straight away talk about the 10 things that you do that God really loves. Number one, when you choose to love God even when you cannot feel Him. There are times you cannot feel God or His love even a little bit. There are times you feel so alone and you feel like God has left you. We should all honestly admit that we do not feel like loving God all the times because of the situations that we are in. Anyone can love God, anyone can love when they feel like loving, but that's not true love. Love is a decision, it's not an emotion. You can choose to decide whom to love and whom not to love. So you should always choose to love God no matter what's going on in your life. Love God even when you're feeling alone, even when you're tired, even when you're worn out, even when your heart is broken, even when your soul is dry. Love God because He deserves to be loved. Love God because He first loved you. He wants your love even when you cannot feel His love. So God loves it when you love Him, even when it's hard to love. Number two, when you trust and obey God, even when it makes no sense. We all know the story of Noah. He was one of the Bible heroes. God told him to build an ark when there was no rain on the land. It made no sense. People were making fun of him for what he was doing, but he still kept on trusting and obeying God. And guess what happened? Yes, everybody on the earth died in the flood except Noah and his family. Grace did not save Noah, obedience did. So at times, you might look like a fool trusting and obeying God when it makes no sense. It may seem like God is not working, but He is. He knows what He's doing. So, you know, sometimes you might look like a fool to people when you're trusting and obeying God when it makes no sense, but to God, you are the hero. Number three, when you choose to forgive even when it's hard. We all know the story of Joseph. He was also one of the Bible heroes. He was a young boy and he obeyed his father, and that's why his father loved him so much. So one day his brothers got jealous and sold him to the Egyptians. So he worked as a slave in Egypt and also he had a very hard time. But once he became the governor of Egypt, his brothers came to him asking for food. So what did Joseph do? Did he take revenge? No, he could have taken revenge because now he's the governor and he could do anything. But he did not take revenge, but rather he chose to forgive his brothers even after what they did to him. So our hearts should also be like Joseph. If you want your heart to be clean, you must know how to forgive others. You must learn to forgive. So yes, God loves it when you choose to forgive even when it's hard. Number four, when you give thanks to Him, even in difficult situations. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verses 16 to 18 says, "Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." It's very easy to thank God when good things are happening to you, when your prayers are getting answered, but it gets really challenging when all the bad things are happening to you, when your prayers are not getting answered, when things do not work out the way you expected. So that's when the real challenging thing begins. That's what the real challenge is. You gotta thank God even when it's hard. Even when you're in difficult situations, doesn't matter what situation you're in, doesn't matter what's going on in your life, doesn't matter how hard your life gets, regardless of what's happening, God is always good. So never fail to thank Him. Of course, don't thank Him for the bad situation you're in, but always find reasons to thank God, and He loves it when you do that. Number 5, when you worship and praise God even when you don't feel like it. Let's take the example of another Bible hero, my favorite worshiper, David. We all know who David was. David was the king of Israel, and before he could get there, he was just a humble shepherd who worshiped and praised God at all times. When he was surrounded by his enemies, I don't think he was in a mood to worship because he was also a human just like you and me. He had feelings just like you and I do. He must have been so scared when he had to run away from his enemies when his enemies were trying to kill him. He had to run from one place to another just to keep himself safe. So it was really hard for him. But the best thing about him was not his skills of hiding nor his talents of playing the harp. The best thing about him was that he was a true worshiper and he worshiped God even when he did not feel like worshiping. Just like true lovers don't love based on emotions, but they love because they decide to love, even the true worshipers don't worship because they feel like worshiping, but they worship because they know that God deserves to be worshiped. God loves and appreciates it when you choose to worship and praise Him even when you don't feel like it. Number 6, when you repent and come back to Him. We all know the story of the prodigal son. He wasted his father's properties and lived his life according to his own will. He did not obey his father, but when he came back to his father, the father ran and he embraced him just the way he was. He did not care if he was dirty, but he went and embraced him. He hugged him, he kissed him. Why? Because he loved him. He had been waiting for him all the days of his life. In the same way, we also get distant from our Heavenly Father at some points of our life. So when we come back to Him, when we repent of our sinful ways and come back to Him, God is always ready to embrace us and He loves it when we come back to Him. Number 7, when you truly desire to please Him. Colossians 3:23. And whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men. Whenever you do anything, do it to please God and not men. In whatever you do, your intentions matter because God is not interested in what or how you're doing something, but rather in why you're doing it. Number 8, when you delight in Him. Psalms 37:4 says, "Delight yourself in the Lord and He will give you the desires of your heart." This verse makes it clear that He loves it when you delight in Him, and that's the reason why He promises to give you the desires of your heart when you delight in Him. So regardless of what's happening in your life, always be happy in the Lord because God loves it when you do that. Number 9, when your tears fall thinking about His love. Have your tears ever fallen thinking about the love of God and the things that He has done for you? Yes, good, because God loves it when you do that. Don't worry if you have never experienced that, you can pray to God to let you experience it. It's really amazing to, you know, feel His love and to cry in His presence. So God really loves it when you do that. So always cry for God, you know, let your tears fall for God because your tears are precious to Him. Now last but not least, number 10, when you choose to do the right thing even when you're the only one. It's very easy to do the right thing when everybody else is doing it, but it's really difficult to do the same when you are the only one. Noah chose to live a righteous life when everybody else was sinning, and Daniel did not stop praying even when the king prohibited everyone from doing so. We can learn a lot of things from the heroes of the Bible, and you can be one in the eyes of God. Be a hero in the eyes of God rather than in the eyes of people. And when you become a hero in the eyes of God, you're gonna shine like the star and no one will ever be able to stop you from shining. So make sure you always do the things that God loves. So now let's review all the things that we've learned. 10 things to do that God really loves. When you choose to love God even when you cannot feel Him. When you trust and obey even when it makes no sense. When you choose to forgive even when it's hard. When you give thanks to Him even in difficult situations. When you worship and praise God even when you don't feel like it. When you repent and come back to Him. When you truly desire to please Him. When you delight in Him. When your tears fall thinking about His love. When you choose the right thing even when you're the only one. If you're blessed through this video, kindly share it with the people you care about so that they will be blessed too. And also don't forget to subscribe for more godly videos. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video.